What's up, y'all? Gerald here, creator of Gospel Chops and your host for this YouTube channel, back with another video. When I first launched Gospel Chops in 2004, our slogan was blessing lives through gospel music instruction. Not blessing music, not blessing musicians, blessing lives through music. Over the years, we've touched millions of lives and influenced the drumming industry in a way that has been uniquely our own. Whenever I counsel young musicians, I always start with their mentality. I assess where they are, and I seek the best path for their personal, spiritual, and musical growth. I try to expand their imagination. But many of the most talented gospel musicians grow up in the hood. And let's face it, that's where a lot of black churches are. You go to the hood, and on every corner, you see a black church, a liquor store, a payday loan outfit, and an abortion clinic. Many of these young musicians don't make it out the hood very often. These are the images that they see on a daily basis. So it's difficult to expand their imagination beyond that. And yet, I try to broaden their vision and get them to see a bigger framework for their lives. I discovered a video where Pastor Mike Todd of Transformation Church put it in perspective beautifully, and I wanted to share it with you. Let's check it out.
1 Chronicles 28:9, God knows my imagination. Let me say it like this to you. Your imagination frames your life. Whatever you're imagining is the frame that God is building your whole life on. The life you have right now, you framed it. Stop blaming everybody else. It's not your family no more. You don't even live in that house no more. You are framing your life with the thoughts that you are thinking right now. And God told me to tell you, it's time to change the frame. What are you saying, Pastor Michael? Let me give you an example that kind of hits close to home. This is a drum set that I want to show y'all from like probably 1821. I don't even know. This mug is old. This drum set was top of the line, world-class drum set when it came out. But it only has the frame for one cymbal, a cowbell, and a snare. That's all the frame can hold. This is our drummer Tony's drum set. This mug is huge than a mug. Now, I want everybody to see this real quick. This drum set is huge. It has a frame that can hold all of these that come with me, because they don't even know. They're seeing it from the front. I want y'all to see how crazy this little boy has gotten with this drum set. No, come on back here. I'm exposing it right now. There's cymbals everywhere. There's electronic pads. There's all kinds of stuff. There's electronic double basses. There's four pedals down here. Do you need all? What's the difference between this drum set and that drum set? It's the frame it was built on. I'm gonna help him. This is what the frame of that drum set looks like. Look at this. This right here is the frame. I need somebody, camera, come on. Y'all, somebody come over here so they can see this. This is big enough to be able for me to imagine. When I build my drum set on this frame, there's all kind of options. There's all kinds of toms and cymbals and everything. That's the only reason that 1921 drum set doesn't have the frame to be able to build something great. God said to me, Michael, the saddest part about this crazier faith message I'm trying to get to people is most of them do not have the frame big enough for what I want to do in their life. They've not believed me. They haven't taken the limit off of me. And today, when I looked at that word yetzer, and it said that the worlds were framed or imagined, and that God knows our frame, our imagination, God said, Michael, The music I want to make in your life depends on the frame that you have. See, many people don't know this, but I've played drums since I was 2. The difference between this drum set and that drum set on the screen is there's a lot more options here. Let me stop. What I was able to do and the sounds that came out and the expressions I was able to make were based on something that was built on a frame that was big enough for me to hold what I imagined. Pastor Mike, what are you trying to say? Could you imagine for more? I feel like it's the rest of the weeks for most of you are going to be futile if you don't get this one point. Make the frame bigger. Take the limit off of God.
Pastor Mike talks a lot about crazy faith, which is also the title of his book, which I'll link down in the description below. Changing the hearts and minds of gospel musicians in a positive way takes a lot of work, dedication, and definitely crazy faith. Whether you're a musician who's been with us on this channel since day one, or a new subscriber who's just discovering our work, we thank you. We appreciate you, and we're glad you're here to join and support as we expand our imagination of what this ministry could be and continue to bless lives. Like the video, subscribe to the channel, and share the video so we can get more musicians involved in the conversation. And like I always say, y'all, always remember and never forget, without the gospel, it's just chops. Until next time, peace.